Okay, so these are long rulers and they're sticking out a bit more than I'd like them to, so I'm just about to cut them off with an angle grinder. And I've chopped them down, so now it's just tuning and decorating. Hi, George.
Hi.
G'day, George.
How are you going? What are you making? I'm going to be making a giant kalimba. I'm going to use steel rulers as my prongs. It's a giant thumb piano. You can still play it with your thumbs.
Can I?
Please do.
Thumb it. Okay, that's awesome.
You look finished.
I know, I've got the bones of it together, so it looks finished. This is just clamped on at the moment, so I need to actually get it onto this space.
So is this a fire pit?
Yes, it's a fire pit. They're useful things.
That you're turning into a musical instrument.
Fire pit and rulers, yeah.
What inspired this?
I like percussion instruments.
Are you a musical instrument player?
Yeah, I play the drums. So I've got a drum kit and a piano set up in my lounge room.
Awesome.
My kids and me.
So when you heard this challenge, you were like, I got this.
No, I wasn't at all. I was a little bit worried this morning. I was like, oh my God, and frantically drawing a picture.
You could do it. Good luck, George, you got
all right,
this.
Mate. See you, George.
Bye, mate. Hey, Andrew.
Hi, folks. Hi,
mate.
Mind if we pull up an A-frame?
Absolutely. Oh. A sawhorse.
Oh,
do you know what this is?
I have no idea.
This is the extremely rare and expensive flundelurpa.
Flundelurpa?
That's correct. I'm going to be creating a wind instrument using an old water pump. In the days before fire extinguishers, you'd put the stirrup pump in the bucket and you'd stand on the stirrup and you'd pump away happily and out would be a little hose and you'd put your fire out. But I've made a musical instrument in it by cutting a bird's mouth, and then when this is pulled out, all of a sudden it comes to life.
So why have you gone for a water pump? What's the significance?
Well, I've got a history of people in the fire brigade, in the local volunteer bush fire brigade. My father did 50 years service and I served in the same unit with him. And this was Dad's. So, you know, one day he used this and I'm using it for a different purpose.
Why the word flundelurpa?
Well, there's no such thing, really.
Oh, yes, yes, the gibberish word, flundelurpa, meaning, Andrew, be creative.
And what's the finish going to look like?
It'll be beautiful, shiny brass.